Oh, good. I thought that whole conversation was recorded, the phone call. Oh, my God. Terrible news. He, of course, called him saying that a good friend of ours that I've known since he was a kid, actually, before he even went to high school, and he just, they don't expect for him to wake up today. He went out last night and came home, and as no one has been able to wake him up. He's 42, and they did the doctors, you know, because he's at the hospital, they're checking his blood and all that. It's like OD on methamphetamine, and so, but he's obese and stuff like that, so we don't know. He's been out of the military for a long time, but it's a shame. A lot of people, I mean, not a shame, it is what it is, but and they think, the family suspects that this is the first time that he's taken the meth, and because he's, you know, military, but I don't know if you, how can your body be clean if you're a beast at this, you know, he was in the military when his youth, he's not in his youth anymore, but still, but they said, and I haven't seen him in a long time, so he's married and has children, but of course, time, and so, yeah, we'll see. It does, it's just sad. It's just sad that I hope, I pray, Lord, you know, please, just, I don't know, just, it's another life. They don't know what, it is what it is. Okay, I'm getting cold. Lower that, and I'm in the village. Oh my God, hold on, I want you to be able to see. Oh, sorry, bees. One moment. Yeah, see, I'm just going through the village, but let me check the radio. Jeez.
It's there for our friends over at King's. Let's go ahead and do Cover Me, brought to you by our gang at Burger King. So excited for Lent because I'm gonna try and eat 40 BK big fishes. There's 40 days in Lent now, which is actually Ash Wednesday, is just Wednesday, so it starts. So my mom cracked me up last night because
all right,
we're eating something, and she was like, oh, I got
too many bumps.
Yeah,
I'm in like my road, so yeah. Well, the road is just,
if you guys,
it's not just the bumps, it's broken roads, crack roads.
Then, I mean, and you adhere
to overly done repaired roads, patches here and there.
This pandemic's getting to me. If I'm calling it Lenten protocol, what the hell? Yeah. So just beat it out until when you got Ash Wednesday, and then you do the whole. And we'll talk about it in the show next week. There's so many different trains of thought. Man, I'm lucky. I know some priests. Maybe we're gonna get Polly Eric or Father Paul or maybe.
Pacific Museum.
The right to maintain control over the show and to keep within the guidelines of the FCC.
Too many commercials,
beeps. If you have any comments or complaints, you can contact SMG. At SMG, we strive to present the best product we can.
We're just heading to Chuddy's.
And we thank you so much for listening.
I hope I caught something.
News Talk K57.
On Mornings with Patty.
Thanks a lot.
Or should I go to 76?
Oh, do we? Yeah, that's usually because of me, but I'm kidding. No, we like to pounce on each other every once in a while. There's no morning is complete if Jeremy and I don't have an exchange of snide remarks at each other. That's what makes it happy.
You're doing an awesome job, man.
Thanks, Brian.
That there are systems out there in the world where you can train your cat to go and do its business
first
in the toilet bowl.
And flush the toilet?
No. It's a cat. Yeah, there's just so much. I mean, it's already doing you a favor. Even just using the cat box, the cat's already doing you a favor. And I'd actually heard that as a reason not to do that with your cats. Look, how tough is a cat box? And you still can't live with something like that. Would you rather clean up all of the kitty cat poo-poo and pee-pee in the house? No, the cat's doing you a favor by doing business there. Why would you add another level of complications to that by insisting that they figure out how to use the commode? Since I've started the subject, you can buy those kinds of things, and after a while, it's a little cat box that goes
construction going on the road, Pete.
And then after a while, you just take it away, and the cat will figure out, or it'll just drown one way or the other with what's going on.
What about when you need the bathroom battery and you walk in there, and the cat's like, I'm in here, dude.
Yeah. You ever see that face they make when you catch them in the box? He's going, why are you looking at me? Stop it, I'm busy.
Yeah, let me go.
I'm sorry, it's a no frowny face Friday. Maybe I take that to a little bit of an extreme. Maybe it's just
it's Friday,
Friday. By the shirt that I have.
2-year anniversary of this pandemic, which is coming up in
two-year
March.
Anniversary.
Okay, so again,
March 11th.
With our cello, Joe Garrido.
March 11th, 2020.
For Joe Sir and the KUAM News Team, my name is Chris. Be safer. Guajanesta.
But it actually happened October, they're saying August of 19.
Blessing off the day, everyone.
Candied salmon, chamorro platters, award-winning gourmet burgers, keto-friendly. They can do that as well. Reservations are suggested, especially on the weekends. 479.
I agree, music is very powerful, and that's the reason why I created this song, was because I was asked to, and in hopes for peace and understanding during this time, I wanted to create this song.
Sit on you, peeps.
You are one of the frontliners here on our island, protecting our people. I want to personally thank you, and I just pray that the Lord brings restoration upon those that are sick and their families, and I pray for safety.
Ric Flair, the wrestler, is 73 years old. Ooh. Carrot Top turns 57. Tia Leone.
Lord. Through the grapevine, heard it through the grapevine. Oh, peeps. Welcome to Sinahanya, peeps. And there's Sinahanya Payless. Welcome to Sin City, peeps. Sinajanya. Heard it through the grapevine.
The 17 miles per hour with gusts as high as 21 miles per hour, and a fire watch remains in effect, Guam. And yes, any fires that develop will likely spread rapidly. Outdoor burning is not recommended.
Hello, my baby. How are you doing? I really miss you.
Ceremony Hill. Oh, there's something going on. Mark.
I'm still in love with you. I still care for you. You are more than. I'm a few shy, but it's gotta have the qualities that I like in a man. Strong, small affection. It's gotta be up on me, and I'll be too easy. Have a good day.
Robin Thicke and Lost Without You. It's 9:14 on Guam's number one hit music station, Hit Radio 100. My name is Ronnie. Morning Millennium is brought to you by the Outback Steakhouse. Congratulations to Pete, Charles, and Zyra, the first three people to get entered for this this awesome free skydive.
Please,
for two people.
Let me take you for a little stroll.
Courtesy of Skydive Guam. Skydive Guam is now back.
Let's go through here. I'm going to make a right here. This is the old government Bank of Guam branch when it used to be very busy here in Iganya. But this is Aniqua. Okay, we're going to go through here. Oh, there's a traffic light here. But I'm going to go over here where the old Dairy Queen used to be, but now it's KFC. And this is the new Shirley's. Well, where the original Shirley started, actually. Oh, it's been so many things, that building. All right, oh, look at the ocean, look at the water. Wow. Peace, this is crazy. I'm gonna try and do this. I'm gonna try and make a right turn here, which I am, okay. Here we go. All the way, peeps, all the way. We're driving in Aniqua. Streets of Aniqua. For those of you in the mainland who haven't seen it in a while, here it is. Aniqua. Or even for that matter, those of you up in Dededo. Here's Aniqua. And there seemed to be something going on up here. Oh. To a truck, but I need to make a turn, right turn here where this truck is up behind it, because that's the turn into Chutney's. Oh, good. More than ample parking at Chutney's. Diamond Auto Parts. I'm sure I missed a lot. It's already 9:15. If there's anything, peeps, let's see. All right, let's get our mask. Turn that baby off. Got the keys in my pocket. Take my bag. Grab you and let's go. And someone send me a newspaper. Push. Alright. Oh, let's see what's on. GDP wrangles over 6.5 million. Okay, and conflict brings uncertainty. Oh, it's still empanada, right? Sold out. Oh, Lord. Peeps, I missed it. Okay, let's see. What's this? This is...
This is tapioca.
Oh, tapioca. It's not the... That other thing. Okay. My God, peeps. There is this banana donuts.
Yeah.
Remember, we cheated and ate a donut and banana last night. This is the real deal. This kind of looks good. I think, yeah, I'm not going to go anywhere else. This is good. This. All right, let me get those. I'll just get two of this just in case. And... I'll get Jesse a tuna sandwich just in case, because he likes that kind of stuff. All right. And you know what? I guess I'll just get two of those. Yeah. Okay, so just missed everything. Get one more. Oh, jeez, I forgot to put my bag. Oh. This is in the car. All
together is 1722.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. Pizza, I'll see you guys.
Would you like a box?
Oh, yeah, sure. Sorry, I know I forgot to bring mine. Yeah, box is nice. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Sorry again.
I know it's all right.
We're gonna get used to this new norm.
I know, right?
Thank you, darling.
Okay, you take care.
All right,
you too.
Sorry about the door.
It's all right, thank you.
You
too. Oh, she's always so nice. She's my relative. I know the young boy doesn't know that we're relatives, but yeah. We're relatives. Everybody's related to Chutney. Who isn't? I mean, you know. If you're eating their food, you want to be related. They have really good, oh my God, I just love their catering. Their food is just awesome. The fried chicken is to die for. Alright. I don't know. I just got that, whatever. Okay. The only place I can stop by to see if there's any empanada would be. Oh my God, there's chickens on the road with their babies. Look, if you can see it behind there. See, on the road. They're everywhere. Look it up. Alright, peeps. Oh my God, look at that. Is that a child? Could be an older lady, you know. Looks like someone from Indonesia. Those ladies cooking something outside. Or preparing a fire or whatever, but I don't think so. Oh, let's go this way, peeps. But really, I'm taking you guys on a stroll to the edge of Anigua. I mean, to the deep Anigua. I mean, there's not much. This is as deep as you can get. I mean, look. The homes. This little corner here. I mean, this is the edge. This is it. This is the end. This is the corner. This is the the cemetery is right behind this apartment and this house. These homes. That's all the cemetery behind it. So, yeah, here's. This is Anigua. But yeah, I'm gonna get out of here because I need to go get empanada. Maybe I'll check this store over here in Maina. Yeah, let's go through there. Let's go through Maina. Why don't we do that? Busy, so one moment. God. Where's everybody coming from? Okay, let's go, peeps. Yep, there's the cemetery. Adela. I'm gonna go here Saturday. My cousins are gonna be here. gone, but never mind. Don't want to do that. Okay, here we are. Probably going to be on that side of the beach. I hope Jesse's able to make it, or that he wants to go. Just showing you peeps. While we're sitting here in traffic, this is Maida. God, God, cooperate with me. Okay, turn green, please. Oh, it's green for the other side to go down south. And that's towards Assen, Petey, going down south. Here we are, peeps. Taking a ride into Maida, where I grew up. Oh, that's right. I'll show you guys. Let's drive by there. Where I was raised, where I was conceived. Maida, this is the village that I was born and raised. For 5 years. Six, seven, maybe, eight. Yeah, I think maybe up to that age. But yep, we're going up. Let's take this stroll. I don't even know if they have a little... They used to have a little... You know, because every village has a convenience store. This little village used to, but I don't think there's any. Been a long, long time. Only when I was younger used to be a convenience store. Oh, if you guys are familiar with Maida, here it is. A really small village on Guam. The central area. I'm from here. Yep. This is my, I go to church here. Which I was just thinking about this morning, I need to go to. I need to start my family going back regularly again. Only because of the pandemic, I just kind of like really just stayed away. Because it's really a small church and, you know, one side sings, the other side breathes and everything. Love it. Maida peeps, welcome to Maida. Maida, we're coming close. This is the bend. I used to walk this bend because the store used to be behind me. I should have showed you guys. But yeah, here's the cruises. I used to, the stairs, this broken home, that stairs, I used to jump off that when I was small. Because they used to sell, they were the house that would sell like soda pops, Pepsi or something. And we'll, I'd go up to their house because I live right behind them. This is my street. And our bus stop was right here. This is where our bus stop was. I think my teacher still lives across these guys. But yeah, this is my village. To my right here, as we're turning down. Oh my God, this is in my dream. This place is in my dream. This is my dream, peeps. It looks like this. It's just that here's where I was born. Let me just drive in. And I'll just reverse. Yeah, that's my Uncle Johnny's house. This is where I was raised. Let me just back up. I'd love to visit, but I have to get back to because this is the driveway. All right, here we are. Maida. I used to look up at this hill always think dinosaurs were behind it because I lived up in this area. But here we are. Now we're gonna go down. Because down here is Maida Bridge. Whoa, look at this place. Wow. Haven't been here in ages. There's the Maida Bridge right below as we come down where there's two metal things on the side. Yep, Maida Bridge going down. Or the White Lady Bridge. Scary, spooky tale at night because there's no, it's so dark here. You don't want to drive through here at night. They say you'll see the White Lady in your, in the back seat of your car. Or if you look at your back rear view mirror, you see the White Lady walking behind your car as you're driving away. But anyhow, here we are. Entering Agana Heights. Alright. Welcome to Agana Heights Beach. Oh my gosh, Lord. Too many bumps. It's knocking you guys off the caddy. Because you're magnetic. I have two big magnets, but it's not that, I guess not that strong. Oh yeah, let's check Nana's store. Maybe Nana's store might have empanada leftovers, hopefully. If not, we're just gonna go home because, Lord, I'm late. But, you know, Jesse's sleeping, so. Here we are, peeps. Nana's store. In Agana Heights. All right, let's do this. Here we go. All right, peeps, I hope. Good morning. Oh, look, there's the food, Pete. Oh, awesome. Oh. Oh, is that empanada?
Yes.
Oh, good. See, oh, lucky. Oh, good. Oh, good. Look, there's stuffy. This is different, the setup. There's more. Oh, my God, Pete, I haven't been here. Yeah, there's pancit. I'll probably get some of it. Or maybe Jesse might like the sushi. Let me get sushi. Yeah, maybe not the pancit, because we have the other stuff. I need, how do I get this? Okay. Yeah, it's okay. I just prop this down. Sorry. Thank you so much. Yeah, I grew up in this village. My family lives in there. I haven't been here in ages.
Okay. Huh?
Oh, you were born here too? You were born here?
No, I was born in Korea.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, I don't know how this opens.
It's hard to open.
Oh, there. Sorry, thank you. This has got to be Tenorio's. I'm just going to get two. Because probably Anna might want it after school. Okay, we got this, and Pete, I'm gonna get this too. All right, I think we're good. Thank you. Wait, one more. Sorry.
That's, no, that's good. It's okay. Yeah. And 11:50.
Okay. All right, peeps. We're late. We gotta go deliver them. Thank you so much. Have a good day. Take care. All right. Here we are. Let's go. That was fun. Let's go inside. There, add that to the rest of the food. At least we have empanada and an assortment of stuff. How's that, peeps? Good. I think we did good. All right, let's get home. Which way do we go? Let's go through... Yeah, let's go through the front since I've not taken you there. I've taken you guys through the village. Let me take you out of the village. And let me, oh my God, breathe. Let's do this, peeps. Better. So make sure you guys can see. God, it's like somebody keeps moving this chair. Better. Leaving Chalon, or I'm getting on Joseph Cruz. Are you turning in, sir, or what? This guy's signaling, but okay, yeah, you are. The view over there, peeps. Oh gosh, that's right. We're just gonna go back up that same way. Never mind. You haven't gone through here. Just enjoy that view while I drive. Yeah, there's people working along the road. Look at the mountain, peeps. Yanya Heights. Charlie Corn. Nimitz Hill. This is behind the school, peeps. Again, yeah, it's elementary school. There's a good friend of mine who used to live in this apartment. One of my best friends. Childhood friend. Was my best friend before I met Melvin English. Well, I've always considered him my best friend up to now. Kenny Bloss. I'll never forget. He's my best friend. And he likes to pee. Sorry, you just fell. I don't know if you're upside down. All right, here we are. Other store here. Probably everybody's selling the same one to Orioles at this time. So never mind. I was thinking of getting some more empanada or something else, but you never know what they have, right? stop sign here, really? It's different. Okay. Yeah, Anna used to go to this school when she was in elementary, Bishop and Gardner. It's a good school. All the stores closed. It was right there by the gate. Here's the school. I'm just gonna go through here. Get out. Sinohanya peeps. All the church is coming up ahead. Oh, CL Titan Elementary School. There's St. Jude School, church.
Continuing to write books as well, story books for children. But forever in my
St. Jude Church, peeps.
I would be able to teach, perpetuate, promote the Chamorro language and culture.
Jimmy, this, I know that there's, you know, Miss Chamorro is in March, but there are other, you know, months in the year in schools where children are focused on our language and the culture. How much easier has
originated
been, or how Sinanya. Has it been since we started requiring
and Payless is, that Sinanya Payless is coming up ahead
that kids are comprehending or understanding?
Hope you enjoyed that straw piece.
From my observations, I believe the students have a great opportunity in learning Chamorro in our Chamorro language and culture program. With visiting scholars from Hawaii, we've actually commended our program in terms of implementing it on such a macro level, because when everybody is afforded this opportunity to learn about Chamorro and Chamorro language and Chamorro culture.
Sorry, you're underneath the chair. I'm glad we're here in the gas station.
That one focuses on the Chamorro dance and chant, and so that's been a big highlight as well.
I might as well get down and see what they have
here. It's a highlight too, and the celebration.
Oh, there you are. You're just right.
Some of our photo documents.
You were by my leg. That was nice. All right, we're here. I had to pull over, so might as well.
And that's really something to
it's a good check.
Celebrate. So in moving forward with the language, we've also expanded to...
Let's do this. It's so dark in here. This thing makes that everything so dark. Hi. Is there any? There's no food. This is it.
3 years ago, our administration.
All right, peeps. There's really nothing. All right, thank you. No, they don't have anything. It's dark in there. Yeah, I wouldn't want to work there. God, that's scary. It's like you can't see the cashier. Everything's dark in the back. Then there's no food. Ah. All right. Well, now I know. Don't stop my mobile. They don't have anything. They never do. Just gas.
A diverse group of other island cultures that have their own language. They have their own mother tongue. How easy is it to have these children comprehend this Chamorro language when they speak their own language from the other islands?
Well, can I just go back? Because I started teaching in 1980, and teaching Chamorro back then.